I thought I deserved a bit of a break. Get away from that. Smoke for a bit. Bit of fresh air. In the traditional British manner. Well, it seemed like a good idea at the time. We're on Goodrington Sands. Whither in the old days great steam locomotives like the city of Truro, King George IV, Pendennis Castle would hie from Paddington. The Cornish Riviera Express, whoosh! The Torbay Express, whoosh! The roof racks packed to the gills on Saturdays, all for a bit of this. Now the station here is on the Paignton Dartmouth Steam Railway, 7 miles long and 30 minutes end to end. The irony is that the Paignton and Dartmouth Steam Railway doesn't actually go to Dartmouth. It goes to Kingsware on this side of the estuary, and then you have to get rather a pretty ferry across to Dartmouth. That's their business, and actually nothing to do with us. Ah! My carriage awaits.
You know, Enid Blyton had to be thinking of a station like this when the famous Five went off on their adventures with Timmy the dog. Did the famous Five include Timmy the dog? Oh, that'll keep me awake tonight. Imagine arriving here after a 4-hour journey from London with your dad telling you to sit still and shut up every 5 minutes. Just look at it. Marvellous. Here we are. Hot foot from Paddington Station. The Torbay Express via Exeter and Newton Abbot, eating the miles up with every cloud of billowing white smoke. And every mile made some little boy's heart beat faster and faster, excitement mounting unbearably. Arriving at last at Goodrington Sands, bucket and spade ready and prime, sand shoes and shrimping nets loaded and cocked.
Excuse me, I wondered if you would do me a small favour. It's a little thing for you, because you do it all the time, but for me it would be a once-in-a-lifetime. I just wondered if I could,
have a cup of your mind.
Oh, gosh, my God.
All aboard!
Oh, this is tremendous. I can understand why you enjoy this. Mind the doors, mind the doors. I think that's London Underground, isn't it? Probably wrong here.
Here you are, right.
Can I blow your whistle?
13, Mike.
Will you be all right now? Oh, this is a golden moment.
Ah!
Thank you. Get on quick or we're dead.
Sorry to leave, actually. Leaving all the fun behind. Still, we can't dawdle when there's a railway to run. Kingsware and the ferry await.
Of all the lines we've visited, this has to be the most typical British holiday seaside line. You can smell the fish and chips and the candy floss. You can taste the sea salt on the lips. No? Well, take my word for it. We're back in an age when polystyrene burger boxes and those awful headphones were as distant to the passengers of those times as London or Birmingham. And you might be travelling with a whole carriage load of cadets, perhaps, from the Royal Naval College Dartmouth. Or are they equally fascinating people?
Up she comes. Come on, girl, one last push. It's 1 in 60 here. This'll sort out the locos and the old boilers. More coal, please, Farley. Let's give them value for money. Now, wasn't that worth it? The best view Devon can offer. Berry Head and over to Brixham. Looks as though the water's bearable. It's probably only 25 below, and quite definitely cold enough to bring tears to your eyes.
I'm standing here, surrounded by ghosts. Fictitious ghosts, admittedly, but ghosts nonetheless. There's Inspector Japp. There's Colonel Hastings. Miss Jane Marple. And I'll pat him on his bald head. Hercule Poirot. There you all are. Now, you've spotted the connection already. What you may not have spotted is the next bit of the connection, which is that we're about to enter Greenway Tunnel. At the other end of Greenway Tunnel, if you look up through the trees, you will see Greenway House, and that was the home of, yes, you guessed it, Agatha Christie. And sitting here is Agatha Christie's grandson, Matthew Pritchard, nonetheless. So you must have used this train, or did you have to change to Torquay when you came to visit grandmother?
No, straight down on the Torbay Express from London. I left school, which had a station called Midgham near Reading, and we went up to London and then caught the Torbay Express with a slightly bigger steam engine than we've got today, and straight down to Churston.
In this and, sort of compartment?
Well, not quite. I mean, it had a, as far as I remember, it had a passage.
And, a corridor train.
And a loo at the end, you know, and all that kind of thing. And but the railway line between Paignton and Churston was sort of beloved because I used to bathe on Broadsands Beach, which is just on our right now, and you could see the train going over the viaduct, which we're just about to go over now. And in those days, children have encyclopedic memories, and I knew all the trains, you know, and what time they went and all that kind of thing. Rather like when we were sitting in my grandmother's boathouse, I knew the names of all the boats that went up the river, and it sort of transport was one of my childish delights, I think. And it was all built around trains. I mean, my stepfather was a great train enthusiast too, and he spent one day poring over the train timetable, and he reckoned that there was a window of opportunity, as he called it, that we could actually walk through the tunnel between trains. That we had, I think, I forget what it was, 19 minutes, because there's only one line, you see, they don't come.
But it's quite lengthy.
Well, we had to be, but anyway, my mother was rather against this trip, as you might imagine, but my stepfather Anthony and I decided we were going to do it, and I had a friend staying. So we duly had one last paw over the timetable and shot down to the entrance of the tunnel and walked at a brisk pace through the tunnel, heart beating, as you can imagine, aged 11 or something like that. But the really embarrassing thing came when my friend chickened out halfway down and he shot back towards the end we'd come from. But we made it to the other end. And there's Elbury Cove over there. We used to...
A fine old bathing house.
Yes, that's right, yes. And it was wonderful summer holidays for kids down there.
How long did your grandmother actually live in the house?
Well, she bought it just before the Second World War, and for £2,000, which she thought was recklessly extravagant.
Yes.
And she was lived there all her. I mean, and she was. I think she bought it in 1938 or 39, and then of course the war broke out, and she was then ejected by the U.S. Navy. Who commandeered it as an officer's mess during the war. So we had, you know, X number of officers living in the place. And actually, they treated it very carefully. When my grandmother came to reclaim it in 1945, she found a large frieze painted around the top corner of one of the rooms, which depicted the US Navy's progress throughout the war, starting in somewhere in Virginia, I can't remember now, and ending up with quite a decent sort of, you know, fresco of Greenway and with a naked lady lying on some cushions, which was, you know, where they ended up. And the US Navy were very polite. They said, you know, they said, Mrs. Mallowan, do you want, we've been sort of doodling on your walls. Do you want us to remove it? And she said, no, I think it's a wonderful historical record of what happened to Greenway during the war. And so there it remains to this day. It's getting a little bit dog-eared, but it's still there.
Legend has it they also left her with 28 lavatories.
Well, there are certainly an awful lot.
We are now entering the Greenway Tunnel.
There you go.
All right, Akira. Somewhere up there, when we get through, here we go. And the house is
absolutely above us now.
Above us now, and you can't actually see it from here.
No, there are too many trees with butterflies in them.
But your mother still lives there?
My mother still lives there. She's lived there now ever since I got married and lived in the family house in Wales. My mother's lived here, and very pretty it is too.
Now, before I'm banned from every railway line this side of the Mendips, don't try walking through the Greenway Tunnel today. Pedestrians in tunnels and steam locomotives travelling at 45 miles an hour in the other direction, don't mix. You have been warned. The River Dart, somewhat larger than when we last saw her back in Buckfastleigh, Now, if you had to choose a venue for a picture postcard photographer's convention, look no further. Imagine letting them loose on this magnificent vista. Off you go, boys. Feast your little shutters on that lot. I'm very lucky to get this special guided tour, digging back in Matthew's memory, allowing me to relive childhood adventures, places long lost, just as he left them hundreds of years ago, just as real and just as sunny. Over there, we have the Britannia Royal Naval College, Dartmouth. That's a sight that must have chilled the hearts of some of our future commanders and rear admirals. Here we are, end of the line, Kingsweir. Dumbleton Hall, is it? I must admit, I don't know a thing about trains, but you can tell this one is very, very special. Oh dear. Very special indeed. 120 tons of schoolboy's dream. Schoolgirls as well, I expect. Standing there, huffing and puffing, simmering, waiting to take us back in time. To quote the old advertisement, supreme in steam. I gather there's a Brunel snack bar here, and given the fact he designed the Tamar Bridge and Paddington Station, apart from anything else, I can hardly wait to see the size of the hot dogs.
And you can see the